Welcome to another
Writing Wednesday!
So this video is just going to be a quick overview on the whole publishing process. If you want more information on anything, leave it in the comments below and I'll either answer it or make a video more specifically about that thing. But a basic overview, here we go. So I'm just going to assume that you have done all of the writing and rewriting properly and you've created a book good enough to be published. That's your first tip, is to figure out honestly if your book is any good. A lot of people are very stubborn about that and they'll insist that their book's good when it's not. If it's your first piece of work, it's probably a piece of, yeah. I'm not being mean, I'm just being honest. Most people's work is not very good, and if you end up trying to publish it like immediately after writing it, it's probably gonna get rejected a bazillion times because of that. But that aside, here's a basic summary of how the publishing process works. Mainstream publishing, you know, the classical, normal way to get published is that you get an agent. To get an agent, you send out query letters. Query letters are nasty little pieces of work where basically you describe your book in one page or less and you make the agent see how absolutely wonderful it is. And that's all you send to the agent. Sometimes you'll send a first chapter. It really depends on the agent. You need to read the submission guidelines to figure that out. But you write a query letter and it has to be the best piece of writing you've ever done. And if the agent is interested, they will request your full book. And if they like your full book, they will offer you representation. Now, at no point in any of this do you have to pay any money. So I'm gonna say this like a million times in this video, but getting an agent costs nothing. How the agent makes money is they take 15% of whatever you earn. So their goal is to sell that book to a publisher. And that's what their job is. They try to sell the books to publishers. If the agent finds a publisher that likes your book, they'll agree to publish it and they'll sign a contract and you agree to financial terms and they will pay you what's called an advance, which is an advance on your royalties, meaning that you get this money no matter what. But if your book's royalties exceed that, after they exceed it, you start earning more money. So that's the basic rundown of traditional mainstream publishing with what's called the Big Six and some other slightly smaller but still very big houses. Now, apart from mainstream publishing, there's indie and self-publishing. Indie publishing is kind of like mainstream publishing in the sense that they buy the rights to print the book from you and then they pay you royalties on it. The difference is that indie publishing houses are very small. Not always very small, but much smaller than the Big Six houses. Quite frankly, they have lower standards of admissions. They also do not usually require an agent, so you can submit and query letters and all that crap directly to them, which is incidentally why most of the books they publish aren't up to the standard of mainstream publishing, because they don't have that agent acting as an intermediary. An agent will pretty much never, ever try to sell a book to an indie publisher. And the reason they don't do that is because 95% of indie publishers do not pay advances, which is no bueno for you. Now, indie publishers really run a gamut. They can go from incredibly impressive, putting out extremely, extremely wonderful books with fascinating covers, and they do a great job of editing, to little bitty things that put out these just god-awful little books that should never have seen the light of day. So it's really hard to summarize the whole indie industry, but that's basically the lowdown on it. It runs a huge gamut. Self-publishing, like the name implies, means you self-publish. You do not have to pay anything for this. You should never pay anything for this. You can go to Amazon's KDP program, which is Kindle Direct, which is the most popular way to self-publish. And you can put the titles directly onto Amazon, so people can buy it on their Kindle. There's also Smashwords and there's some other services I'm not all that familiar with, but pretty much you can put an ebook wherever ebooks are sold. Advantages to that are that you don't have to split your royalties with anybody. You have complete control over it. You don't have to wait 6 months to a year like you do with a lot of publishers to have your book published, and you have complete control over it. And the disadvantage of it, obviously, is that you don't have any team behind you. You don't have editors. You don't have a marketing team. You don't have cover artists. You have to do everything yourself. I'm gonna be as frank as possible in this video. So if you self-publish, you will not make much money. There it is, it's said. The biggest success story I've ever heard firsthand from self-publishing was a guy who had his book go up to the top of Amazon charts due to a little bit of controversy, and he said he ended up grossing about $30,000 after taxes. Now you're thinking, $30,000, that's not bad. And it's not bad, I could live off that for a year. But that was extraordinarily uncommon for a book to get that high. The more average paycheck you can expect from a self-published book can range anywhere from 50 cents to $50. And I'm being very serious right now. So that's the three main types of publishing. There are other publishers called vanity presses, which wants you money to print your book, and do not do that. That's a scam. Don't do it. Okay, I've made a whole video about that. You can go watch that if you want to know more about it. But it's a scam. Somebody asks for money, kick them in the balls and run away. Okay, so here's some basic tips. Just, I'm going to run down them real quick. Prepare to be rejected a lot. Even if your book's very good, it's going to get rejected a lot. Most people talk about 100 to 500 agents reject their books. And these are people who eventually get an agent and get the books published. Harry Potter got rejected like 15 or 20 times. Twilight got rejected. And I mean, yeah, it's a bad book, but it ended up making a lot of money. Stephen King famously had a nail stuck into his wall. And whenever he got a rejection slip, he would push it onto that nail on the wall. And he said that after about a year, there was no room left on the nail. And he had to put a big old spike, and that got filled. So he had to put another spike. So it doesn't matter really how talented you are. It doesn't matter how good you think your book is. It's going to get rejected a lot. Agents get tens of thousands of submissions a year. So prepare to be rejected. Next tip, spend a lot of time on your query letters. I'm talking at least a week on each letter. Make sure it's the best thing you've ever written. That agent is only going to see that query letter. That's it. They're going to spend 5 minutes on you. You have to impress them. Do not just rush a query letter and send it out. Make sure it is extraordinarily well written. It's the best thing you've ever written. Make sure, absolute sure, that it's grammatically correct. If you have a typo in there, that's pretty much an instant bye-bye by most agents. If you self-publish, you decide that your book is good enough, dang it, make sure you only do it in ebook. There's POD, which is print on demand, which will put your book into a paperback thing that you can buy from Amazon and other places. But POD books are ridiculously expensive. They're like 15 bucks for a paperback, and you're never gonna sell many of them. You might sell them to a few friends and family and stuff like that, but you're never gonna sell them. And unfortunately, once you put something into a paperback, it has an ISBN assigned, and it will pretty much never go away. Those books will crop up on eBay and Amazon used for the rest of your life. And if you had to self-publish it, I'm going to be completely honest with you, it's probably not a very good book. And if writing is a career for you, you're going to be embarrassed by it later on in life, and you're going to wish it didn't exist. Ebook, you can pretty well make them vanish. Print copies, not so much. My biggest tip, never pay. Never pay anything. The only thing you ever pay is postage. Even that, now, everybody uses email, so you don't have to pay that. Never pay. It doesn't cost anything to get published. Never pay. While you're doing the whole querying and submissions things and getting all these rejection letters, don't just sit around spending all your time trying to sell that book. Write something else, okay? Just spend your time writing something else. Otherwise, you'll get hopelessly depressed and your talents as a writer will never improve. Start writing your next thing immediately. And while you're writing, don't write blogs. Unless you want to be a blogger, don't write blogs. This is something that's huge in the indie world. So everybody's like, oh, you need a blog. You need to write 2 blogs a week. Don't waste your time writing blogs. Nobody's going to read them. If somebody does, they might buy your book once, but then what are they going to do? Because you don't have another book. Spend your time writing fiction. You'll get better, and you'll have more stuff to publish. Honestly, if you want to be a blogger, now I'm not saying that if you want to be a blogger, don't blog, but if you don't want to be a blogger, you want to be a fiction writer, then write fiction, not blogs. You can write an occasional one, okay? I'm not smashing blogging, but seriously, go write a short story or something.